Scientists, why you should never ever cook with aluminum foil. 7. Aluminum and health effects. Scientists are continuously exploring the health effects caused by high level of aluminum intake in our daily lives. Just as smoking can damage our lungs and overexposure to UV rays can damage our skin, similarly, the overexposure of aluminum in our body can result in some serious health risks. Several studies have suggested that high level of aluminum intake can cause significant damage to the human body, such as with renal impairment, reproduction issues, and certain bone diseases. This happens when the amount exceeds than the capacity of the human body to excrete. If not excreted properly, the aluminum is deposited in our bodies and gives rise to various health problems. 6. World Health Organization, WHO, standards. The fact is, 7 to 8% of the Earth's crust comprises of aluminum, and thus life on Earth has evolved in the aluminum-rich environment. And due to this reason, humans have been adapted to aluminum exposure over a long period of time. Every human body is suited for perfectly releasing a small amount of aluminum perfectly. Apart from some food items, the aluminum sulfate is also used in the process of purifying water. That means, we do ingest aluminum some way or the other. However, the permissible amount of aluminum for a human body, as per World Health Organization, WHO, is 40 milligrams per kilogram. 5. A leading cause of Alzheimer. Alzheimer has direct connections with exceeding intake of aluminum, as many of the formal inquiries into aluminum toxicity are especially concerned with its association with Alzheimer, as per studies. According to researchers, excessive aluminum intake can lead to degenerative symptoms including Alzheimer. Aluminum is also considered as one of the most influential neurotoxins associated with Alzheimer. Apart from that, water with high aluminum and low fluoride concentration are associated with Alzheimer for sure. 4. It's bad for your brain. Aluminum is said to produce toxic and oxidative stress in the brain. It is a potential risk factor in cognitive impairment in old age group people, as it has been proven by a study which showed that elders having cognitive impairment had aluminum levels 20 times more than a middle-aged group. Aluminum is recognized as one of the several metals known to affect the human's neurological system. And as discussed above, the supreme brain health concern is the Alzheimer's disease. 3. Aluminum leaches while cooking. The researchers clearly state that there is a certain amount of aluminum that leaches when the food is cooked with aluminum foil. However, the amount of aluminum leach depends upon the type of food and temperature at which it is being cooked. Aluminum is more likely to leach into foods that are spicy, acidic, and liquid food solutions like lemon and tomato juice. The acidic food sparks an aggressive process that dissolves thin layers of aluminum into food. Leaching level climbs up even more when the temperature is raised and spices are added to food. 2. Foods and utensils. Aluminum is one of the most widely distributed metals on Earth and is used in the making of many everyday products. Aluminum is present in corn, yellow cheese, salt, herbs, spices, and tea. Even the flour and some vegetables that we use have aluminum in it. This shows that our bodies are prone to a decent amount of aluminum naturally. 1. Note protection. As discussed above, the pots have a coated layer that prevents leaching. But cooking food with foil paper is a completely different story. Like how we can make an inner layer in pots by boiling water several times, this layer cannot be created with the foil, as it is disposable and cannot be used repeatedly other times. The foil itself is not oxidized, and there's no way of creating a protection layer prior cooking, because of which the scientists are advising against it. Reactions caused by the direct interaction of aluminum's volatile nature with heat contribute to increasing leaching during the cooking process due to high pH level, particularly with spicy foods and foods that are highly acidic. If you like this information, do not forget to share it with your family and friends. Thank you very much for watching us.